Kasm just released Workspaces version 1.14, and as usual, there was a lot of really great progress made and a lot to review in this release video. First, you will see a lot of new UI updates. The previous release focused on the end user UI, and this release focused more on the admin UI, with major updates to table views and how objects are managed. The left panel has been rearranged into a hierarchy for better organization as we continue to expand the capabilities of the platform. We've added webcam pass-through for container-based sessions and local printing for both container and Microsoft Windows-based sessions. First, let's enable both features in the group settings as they are both off by default. When I launch a containerized session, I will be able to enable the webcam through the control panel. I will use VLC Player to quickly demonstrate. I'll use a Windows session to demonstrate local printing. When you go to print a document, you will see a Kasm printer listed. When you select this device, it'll pop out your local print dialog where you can select a local printer to print to. Next up is S3 Persistent Profiles. This allows Kasm to use S3 compatible service to store user profiles. For this demonstration, I will use Wasabi, a lower cost alternative to AWS S3 storage. I've created an empty bucket called Matt Development. Next, I will create programmatic access keys and then add them to Kasm's global settings in the storage section. Let's then edit a workspace. Scroll down to the persistent profile path. This field previously existed and behaves the same way if provided a file path. If, however, you provide an S3 path, Kasm will switch to using S3 for the workspace's persistent storage. Use the format s3:\bucket_name@s3endpoint/your_path. If you are using AWS S3, you may leave off the @endpoint. But since I'm using Wasabi, I need to provide a non-default endpoint. You can also use an endpoint if you are in AWS and using GovCloud or need to specify a private VPC endpoint for S3. Save your changes. That's it. Now let's create a session. Let's open up Chromium and save a favorite to test out persistence between sessions. Now we'll close the session. Let's check the Wasabi dashboard. We can see that a folder structure was created per our settings, and there is one layer and one manifest file in the bucket location for my user. Let's spin up a new session and ensure things are back where we left off. You will notice that when S3 profiles are enabled, workspaces don't load instantly. When S3-based profiles are enabled, the session is loaded asynchronously, and the user is provided a status tracker while they wait for their session to come up. The trade-off is that S3 is more scalable, more secure, and easier to configure in a distributed environment, and provides easy backups and data retention. Speaking of storage, we've added support for users to map in their cloud storage. First, the administrator needs to configure cloud storage for the target. Kasm supports Dropbox, Google Drive, Nextcloud, Microsoft OneDrive, and S3. These can be personal accounts or organizational accounts. I've already configured my organization's OneDrive. Each user will need to go to their profile settings to connect their account to Kasm. When a user adds OneDrive, they will be directed to log into Office 365 and then redirected back to Kasm. I already set up mine, so let's launch a session and see what happens. Here in the file manager, we can see a shortcut to the OneDrive location. It is important to note that cloud storage accounts are not the same as persistent profiles. Cloud storage providers are a convenient way to access cloud storage from within your Kasm session. This is not the location where Linux applications save persistent data. Therefore, these features should be used together, as appropriate for your use case. Both cloud storage and S3 persistent profiles are currently only available for container-based sessions, with support for Windows coming down the road. Windows support gets a big boost this release with a major update to the optional Windows agent. If the Windows agent is installed on the back-end Windows system, a host of new features are available to the administrator and users. Make sure you use the latest version of the agent and read the docs for full details. Let's look at some of the new features, starting with file mapping. File mapping was supported on container-based sessions and is now available for Windows. You can define file mapping at the user, group, and workspaces level. I'll quickly demonstrate a workspace level file mapping of a PowerShell script. I'm going to place the PowerShell script at a specific location under Program Files, Kasm, Scripts, Session Start. Scripts placed here will be executed just prior to the user session being created, allowing administrators a hook to automate tasks. Now we'll create a session and see if the file exists in the defined location. Let's check the file contents. I already enabled debug logging, so let's look at the logs to verify that the script was executed. Here we can see the script output. File mapping can be used for many purposes, not just adding PowerShell scripts for our agent. The next Windows feature added is that Kasm can now manage local Windows user accounts. If this is enabled, Kasm will create local Windows user accounts during the session create time if it does not already exist on the server. The Windows username is a combination of the first 9 characters of their username and the last 10 characters of their Kasm user ID. Each time the user creates a session on a Windows system, a long, random, one-time password is generated. This allows multi-user Windows servers to be used without Active Directory, greatly simplifying Windows desktop architecture for some use cases. A few notes for the new Windows service. The Windows session is automatically logged out when a user terminates their Kasm session. Finally, the installation process and configuration of the new agent has been greatly simplified. There are 2 new big features for autoscaling that really help drive down costs for cloud-scaled compute. As a reminder, pools are a collection of similar servers that can be used for container or VM-based sessions. Once you create a pool, you can either manually add servers or you can define an autoscale setting. The first cost-saving feature is the ability to create auto-scaled schedules. Once you have created an auto-scaled config, you can then go in and edit it and add schedules. You can add multiple schedules to the same auto-scale configuration. When any one of the schedules is on, the auto-scale configuration is enabled. You can create multiple auto-scaled configs for a single pool, each with its own schedule. The next cost-saving feature is session queuing. In previous releases, if there was no compute available for a user's session request, the user would get a nasty message stating that there were no resources available. With Kasm Workspaces 1.14, Kasm will provision the auto-scaled resources on the fly, and the user will get a nice progress tracker as the infrastructure is being deployed to service their request. With this feature, admins can set the minimum available sessions in the auto-scale settings to a low number or even 0. This reduces cost by not requiring idle servers to handle session requests. This will, of course, increase session load times for users. The final major feature is the added support for VMware vSphere as an autoscale provider. With this feature comes the ability for Kasm to autoscale on-premise as well as in the cloud. Be sure to check out the full list of new features, enhancements, and bug fixes in our documentation.